Okay, welcome back friends in this new video. Now, we are going to study the indicators. The indicators are those substances which are used to determine whether the given substance is acidic or basic. Now, indicators are generally the solutions or the substances which are used for the determination of the substances which are generally acidic and basic. Now, for example, phenolphthalein remains colorless for acids and its color changes to pink for the bases. So it means that phenolphthalein acts as an indicator for the base as well as acids. Now, if you consider the solution which is acidic and if you add few drops of phenolphthalein into it, it remains colorless. Now similarly, if you add some drops of phenolphthalein into the bases, it will turn to pink. So generally, this phenolphthalein is called as an indicator or acid-base indicators. Now, second example is of methyl orange, which changes to red in color for acids and it changes to yellow for the bases. Now, if the solution is acid, the color will change to red for the methyl orange and the color will change to yellow for the bases or the basic solution. So, to determine the substance which is acidic or basic, we have to use few other substances or solutions which are called as the acid-base indicators or simply the indicators. So, for example, we can take phenolphthalein and methyl orange as shown here. Apart from phenolphthalein and methyl orange, there is another type of solution called as a litmus solution, which is a purple dye obtained from the lichens. And it remains purple in color for the neutral solution and it may change the color for the acidic and basic solutions or acidic and basic medium. So, litmus solution can be also used as an indicator. Now, there are some other types of indicators called as olfactory indicators. Now, this olfactory means they are related to the smell or odor of that medium. So, olfactory indicators are generally are onion, vanilla and clove oil. So vanilla has a pleasant smell, we know this, and for the acidic solution it does not change the smell of the vanilla. That means the vanilla extract has a pleasant smell and if you add acidic solution and vanilla, so you will know that the smell will not change, but for the basic solution the smell can change. Therefore the vanilla can be considered as an indicator. So vanilla free indicators means it can be used for the determination of the acidic or the basic solution. Now let's see few reactions of acids with metals. Now generally when acids combine with the metal, metal displaces hydrogen from the acid and it will form salt and hydrogen gas. So the hydrogen which is displaced from the acid is released as a hydrogen gas when the acids reacts with metal. So for example, we can take hydrochloric acid when reacts with sodium, it will give NaCl and hydrogen gas is released. So this is the balanced equation, 2HCl plus 2Na, it will give you 2NaCl plus H2. Now, this is the equation from the carbon compounds. This is acetic acid, or you simply can say that ethanoic acid. Now here the hydrogen is present. This hydrogen is displaced by this sodium. And when the hydrogen is displaced by sodium, it is released as a hydrogen gas. So you will get sodium acetate as a product, which is a salt here, and hydrogen gas is released in this process. So reactions of acids with the metals, we will get salt and hydrogen gas. So this one is a strong acid and this one is a weak acid. This HCl is considered to be a strong acid and CH3COOH, that is acetic acid or ethanoic acid, considered to be weak acid. But when they react with the metal, they will release the hydrogen gas after displacing the hydrogen from the acids. Now consider the reactions of the metals with the strong bases. Now, strong bases are generally also called as an alkali. That means alkali, when react with metals, gives you salt and hydrogen gas. Consider the first example, 2NaOH, that means sodium hydroxide, then react with the zinc, it will form sodium zincate, that is Na2ZnO2, and in that case, hydrogen is released. So, this one is very important for our understanding of the reaction of alkalis with metals. So, alkalis, when react with metals, they will give you salt and hydrogen gas. That hydrogen comes from the alkali. So, NaOH, after reaction with zinc, it will give you sodium zincate, which is a salt, and hydrogen gas is released in this process.